those who are online and those who are offline. So last time we were seeing the cloud security part. I guess we saw what was SaaS, what was PaaS, what is IaaS, Infrastructure as a Service, availability about all three things, access control again of all three things, and data security and storage. Alright, this was completed. Today we will focus ourselves in the first for the first half of this particular unit, and we'll try completing it. Tomorrow also there is a lecture schedule from 1:30 to 5:30. Alright, so if not today, definitely tomorrow we will be completing this unit and starting with another unit. Mostly I'll be starting with unit number 2, which is network security. It is although even mobile security is that of the same importance, but network security is a bit technical to understand, so it will require some guidance from my side, or rather from anyone. You will require a bit of help, bit of a tap on shoulder. Mobile security, if at all it is not covered tomorrow, we'll see whenever we get the next session. Alright, that is more of a theory, mobile security. Not much of a practical, although it has some practical inclination about attacking 802.11 networks, but it is more from a theoretical perspective. Alright, it is not much in detail for this entire curriculum. So unit 4 is not much technical. Something which is technical will require some intervention. Alright, before that, did you have a networking subject earlier in your curriculum? Data communications or networking? Alright, so did you come across something known as IDS, IPS? Intrusion Detection System, Intrusion Prevention System, Anomaly? Something which is, no, this was not there. Alright, so I guess you must be having it, but till a certain level. So you must have touched everything, but did not, might not have come across everything in depth. Fine, theek hai. Kerberos systems? No? Alright. So any of these terms are you familiar with? ACL, what is ACL? Packet filtering? Militarized zone and demilitarized zone? Aware about it? Alerts and audit? This is okay, that is fine. Signature based, IDS, IPS, anomaly based, policy based, and honeypot. What exactly can be a honeypot, going by the name?
Honeypot is something that you are transferring to some false sense of security, and then when they try to attack, then they can somewhere.
Right, right. Even if we don't try to attract someone, someone ideally may, just for the sake of fun, try attacking our the website. So there can be something which has been specifically set up for those type of attacks. You can search for smoke screen. Alright, just search for this one word, smoke screen, and how does it not allow any attack to happen. Okay, post this session and before we start with the next session. Fine, just search for smoke screen and honeypot. What is the relation between honeypot and smoke screen? Alright, okay. We now again come to cloud security. Any doubt till here? If you must have read, I'm expecting that you have gone through the study material at some point of time. If you have any doubt, you can let me know. No doubt till now? Those who are online? Alright. So, if we focus on an individual topic over here, it says how concepts of security apply in the cloud. You are going to talk about CIA of cloud over here. Confidentiality, integrity and availability, how it applies to the cloud. Alright, that is this particular thing. User authentication in the cloud is same as user authentication in operating system or user authentication in DB. Because in the cloud, either there will be an operating system or there will be an application. So application authentication or operating system authentication. Alright, or a combination of both can be the answer of user authentication in the cloud. Alright, keeping in mind with what type of cloud is it, or what type of deployment is it? Is it a software that have been provided, that has been provided as a service. If it is software, then majorly operating system authentication won't be coming in the picture. Understood? Alright, see, we are talking about user authentication. So, where will user authenticate itself? So, possibly, if it is only software as a service that we are providing to the user, user may have his own operating system. So, our exposure over there may not be that much, but since the user is using our application, how do we authenticate if that is the right user? So, credential manager should be there, role-based access control, RBAC should be configured at our end to identify that what particular role is that particular person holding. Alright, so those types of every authentication measures or preventive measures that we have seen in operating system as well as database. Alright, that will be applied to the cloud, because either we will be providing an operating system plus application as a service, or we will be only providing application as a service, which is software as a service. Alright, how the cloud provider can provide this. Alright, so we right now are dealing with something known as virtualization system security issues. So we have gone through cloud security issues, some of the issues that the cloud face, that if there is no internet, availability is a major concern. Alright, apart from confidentiality and integrity, which is also a good threat, but if the availability is not there, you may not even know what is the confidentiality, or was the confidentiality hampered or tampered. Right, so availability was on the top priority, followed by confidentiality and integrity at the same position. So let us start from here till we reach this point. Right, storage considerations. You can refer to these slides. For virtualization, we need to first understand what exactly is meant by a virtual system. All right, if I just say that there are two types of system, basis, how do we see it? There will be one type which we can actually see it, a physical system. I can see a system on the left hand side of mine, I can see a system on the right hand side of mine. So there are two physical systems right beside me. Alright, then there can be one particular system which can be installed in my right hand side PC, on which there is another system beside it. That type of system is known as virtual PC, virtual system. So there are multiple open source virtual PCs available. Alright, one of them is, if there is no need to go in detail technically, then the best one is Oracle VirtualBox. It's a very simple software, you just install it. It's an intuitive software, it has colorful buttons, you can press on start, what will it do? It will give you some options. Why? What do you want this software to do? Do you want to install a particular operating system, or do you want an already installed operating system to be started inside your PC? Alright? So, one of those softwares is Oracle VirtualBox. The other software is VMware's ESXi. Alright, so we'll learn more about ESXi. ESXi is directly a part of our syllabus, although Oracle VirtualBox is not. Still, there is a difference, my small difference between ESXi and VirtualBox. ESXi is bit not intuitive to understand, bit unintuitive. Alright, there is not much of a GUI. So you need to be technically sound with the prerequisites of an operating system. That what is meant by a virtual machine, what is meant by a process, a processor, what will the paging file do to your particular operating system? How much paging file size should be there of your operating system? Alright, how much RAM should be configured for your operating system? So such things need to be known as a prerequisite for configuring any type of virtual PC, virtual system. Alright, there are some types of virtual PCs that can be given as a service when we are talking about cloud. So it is cloud for the user, but for us it will be our server. Alright, the user may not know where the server is, but for us, if we are the service providers, we need to know where the server is, how the server is has been configured. Alright, so there are some types of virtualization. For example, if you can see the first diagram, is it visible there? Is it readable? See, let me show you this part. Alright, let us quickly see the properties of this particular PC. As of now, the properties of this PC is it is having a processor of i3, Intel i3. Alright, and the installed RAM is 8 GB. Type of the system is 64-bit. So, if I tell you that we can install multiple PCs inside this one PC. So, there is this Windows PC right now as our host PC. Then, there can be one more operating system entirely installed over this Windows, which can be say Ubuntu or for that matter any other flavor of Linux or some Intel version of Macintosh, Apple PC. Alright, that can also be installed using that particular software, which is known as virtual software. Fine. So, if we intend to give memories, different types of memories to those operating system, tell me how much of maximum RAM can you allot? How much maximum RAM can be allotted if there are say two different systems to be installed? You are visualizing that two different systems will be installed on this Windows 10. So, what is the maximum RAM that can be allocated? Maximum can be 8 GB. So, you definitely cannot allocate if say you are installing Windows, trying to install Windows 8 over Windows 10. Sorry, not over, inside Windows 10. And parallelly, you are also trying to install Ubuntu or any, for that matter, any other flavor of Linux inside Windows 10 again. So, will it be feasible if you give 6 GB RAM, if you allocate 6 GB RAM to Windows 8.1 or Windows 7 and again 4 GB RAM to Ubuntu when your intention is to simultaneously run both the operating systems? That won't be feasible because 6 plus 4 will be 10 and whereas you only have 8 GB of RAM. So these are few things that we need to know. Alright, few logical things that we need to be clear with. Alright, but there can definitely be a provision to set up two different computers inside this Windows 10 of 2 GB RAM each. One Linux can be set up with 2 GB RAM, one Windows again can be set up with 2 GB RAM. So, both the PCs running simultaneously will still consume not more than ideally 4 GB RAM. Okay, we will still have 4 GB RAM as a buffer for ourselves. Fine. So, it is advisable ideally if the RAM is 8 GB, do not allocate more than 6 GB to a particular guest operating system. So that you still have some RAM left for the host operating system. If it is 8 GB and you will allocate 4 GB, there will be nothing left for the host itself but in that case. So even if it is 8 GB, you ideally should allocate not more than 6 GB to all the operating systems collectively if the intention is to run them in parallel. Alright. So having said this, there are some types of virtualization. If you see the first diagram, there is this x86 architecture hardware. So, if I say that there is a system right on the on my right hand side, that physical hardware will have an architecture, mostly x86, which is still persisting in our system. So, x86 hardware structure will have its own virtualization layer. Alright, two types of host. There is something known as full virtualization. Alright, again inside that there are two types of full virtualization. So, full virtualization says that you have the entire system at your end and collectively you are providing this as a service to the client, to the user. So, the user may only need a browser. For example, we only need a browser to view Gmail on our browsers. We don't need any other software. Alright, all we need to do is go on to a browser. If we have an active internet connectivity, we can simply log in. We don't even know where the server is. We don't even know what are the services running in the background. We don't even know for that matter if it is a single server or a virtual server. Server installed inside another server. Alright. So, as a user one may not know, but if you are the provider, you need to know these two types of full virtualization. So, let us keep the Gmail thing, Gmail's example in our mind and understand this. So, x86 architecture hardware server will be there at Google, alright, followed by there can be a simple virtualization layer. Virtualization layer says that there is no operating system installed on the physical system. There is only one particular application that is running, which will do the job of allocating tasks. It is not Windows 10, as we saw over here. There is this Windows 10. Alright, so you can relate it to this particular diagram. There is host operating system kernel. So Windows has its own DOS kernel. Alright, this is the kernel installed. There can be a system set up without Windows 10, but that can still install multiple operating systems inside it. Alright, why is it done in this way? I'll explain in few minutes. First, let us understand the type of architecture. Alright, so x86 architecture hardware followed by there can be a Windows 10. Hypothetically speaking, Google's case, there can be a Windows 10 ka host operating system. Then over that Windows 10, there can be a virtualization layer. They could have installed a similar. I'll just show you what it is. Rather than imagining, let us get into details. So you can simply search Oracle VirtualBox, alright, whichever is the current version, you can download it for the Windows host if you are having a Windows PC, alright. As soon as it gets downloaded, I'll open it in front of you, try installing it. If it is successful, see the environment, see how intuitive it is. Basis that we can actually gauge that what can be done with this particular software. Okay? So it has been downloaded. Let us install it if it is allowing us to. Alright. See, while installing itself, it says, do you want USB support? So you can actually prevent USBs over here. That any other system which will be installed inside this Windows 10 will not have USB feature. You cannot connect anything to that particular system logically as a USB. Alright, that can be done over here. Fine. Networking. You can decline networking. That if there are multiple computers that we intend to install inside this Windows 10, say we intend to install one Ubuntu desktop which will have 2 GB of RAM and one Windows 7 operating system which will again have 2 GB RAM. So Windows need not talk to Ubuntu and vice versa. Alright, so for that we can simply disable this networking. Alright, by seeing this you can also make out the features of a virtual machine. Features of virtual machine is you can still get a USB support inside the virtual machine. Even if it is not physical in nature, there can still be something known as configuring a printer as a USB inside the operating system. Alright, so even if it is not physical in nature, there can still be something known as networking inside the logical system. So again, hypothetically speaking, Windows 7 can still have still communicate with Ubuntu and vice versa. They can talk to each other, basis IP address and other stuffs. Alright, that is one of the features. If you want Python support in this specifically, there is something. Alright, let us try installing this thing. So, what could be advantages of this particular system? One of them would be, even if the system inside this Windows 10 that we are using right now gets corrupt, there is no need for us to reinstall our Windows first and then install that particular operating system. We can simply delete that particular file, entire operating system as a file. Shift-delete kar do, but delete ho jayega. It is as simple as that. Alright, and if we have earlier copied and pasted that particular setup, the same setup use karke, we can again fix the entire thing. Again within few minutes. Alright, no need for us to reformat our system and then install that particular entirely, the operating system. Alright, so it will beautiful way, it will help our base operating system not to crash and not to reformat every time when there is an error. Alright, reformatting should always be the last option. What can we do? We can simply use it as a software. Alright. See this. Very intuitive. It just has few buttons. What are the preferences? So inside preferences, you will get to know what are your RAM preferences, where do you want to save this entire operating system. Alright. How will it be updated? Which type of language would you want to use? Alright. For example, say you are learning German. You want to set up an entire operating system in Germany. In German. So you can simply choose German from this particular set of languages and install the entire operating system and use it in German. Very simple. It will not affect your Windows 10 as of now. The base operating system, also known as host. Fine. What type of display will it have? Will it have a standard display or will it have an HD display? What type of network connectivity could be there? Alright. Is there a proxy that you need to set up? So all these things can come under preference. This list will also go long when we have some operating systems installed over here. We can simply click on that operating system and set its special preference. Alright, so this can go long. If we want to set up a new thing, see, it is by default having some values, and you can clearly see if we select Microsoft Windows, it is showing us all flavors of Windows. Which type of window do we want to set up? So it even has support, by the way, for XP, for Windows 95 if you want to set up. Alright, so any legacy system, if you just want to see and need to know what exactly was there in Windows 95 that was started. Alright, the era where everything in GUI started, graphical user interface. So you can simply install Windows 95 on this Windows 10. Over this Windows 10, and it will ideally not affect your Windows 10 at all, because it is inside Windows 10. It is not along with your Windows 10. Alright, so you just need to give a name and then press next. See, this is the place where you will be actually allocating the RAM. So it shows that we have a RAM size of 8192 MB, which is 8 GB, approximately 8 GB. Alright, it shows us two different colors. Till the time I am keeping it as 5 GB, roughly 5 GB, it is in the green zone. This much is not advised because any further allocation will give a load to your base operating system. Alright, that is why I said initially that if it is 8 GB, try never crossing 6 GB for that matter. So 6 GB already is a load for this particular PC. Alright, this particular PC is allowing its green zone to only be till 5 GB. So if there are two PCs to be set up, let it be 2 GB and 2 GB. So 4 GB is utilized and 4 GB is still free for the host PC. Fine. So we can definitely dynamically allocate the RAM. Similarly, we can dynamically allocate the hard disk. We can have a fixed size of hard disk that this particular operating system will have a dedicated 80 GB space from my 1 TB hard disk, or we can set it up as a dynamic memory. So every time whenever there is something installed inside the PC, which we are right now trying to install, the size will simply increase, and anything which has been uninstalled, the size may decrease. Alright, that can also be set up. Fine. The moment I press on create, it will actually create it, which my intention is not to do so as of now. My intention was only to let you know what can be done in virtual PC. Alright, so understood what can be done. So once you set up one entire Windows machine over here, you can again click on new and now set it up for Linux. What type of Linux do you want to install? It can be Ubuntu 32-bit, it can be Ubuntu 64-bit. Alright. Again, it will go in the same loop. How much of RAM do you want to allocate? Alright, what will be the hard disk size? Again, the same thing follows. Fine. So this is something that we are right now studying. The virtual box itself. Alright, not by going by the name, the virtual box, but by the name virtualization or virtual PC. In some textbooks, you may find it as virtual machines, VMs. Fine. So there is one more vendor which gives VMs. It is known as VMware. VMware. Alright, the tool which is very famous for it is ESXi. ESXi is VMware's product. Alright, we will again come to ASXI as and when the topic comes. First, let us understand the basics of virtualization. So, just now what we saw on our screen was a virtual machine. Alright, now keeping that in mind, let us continue with this. So, we have this again by our current example, we have an x86 architecture hardware over here, physically available. Over it, there is an host operating system kernel, which is DOS for Windows 10, which we have right now. Over there, over it was something which we installed, the virtualization layer, which we installed of Oracle VirtualBox. Alright, that is something that we installed. Inside that entire layer, technically speaking, with this perspective of the diagram, over this virtualization layer, we can set up an entirely logical virtual hardware. Although the name is hardware, it is logical, pretty much logical in nature. Alright. Also, it will definitely be consuming the physical hardware for sure. Okay. So we can set up a virtual hardware. We can allocate the RAM, we can allocate the hard drive size, we can select the operating system, if it is Windows, if we want to install a Macintosh, Apple, PC, Intel version, or if we want to install Ubuntu for that matter, or for that matter, any particular operating system. And then inside that operating system also, we can install Java, we can install JDK, we can install a different application, user specific application, so that can also be done. Alright, so this is that particular time. Fine, so virtual machine 1 can contain all these things. Simultaneously, we can also have another virtual machine configured with the same thing and another virtual machine, as long as the physical hardware allows this system to create and run everything simultaneously. Alright, till the time we exhaust everything, we can actually make multiple operating systems inside a single operating system. Fine, that is known as virtual operating system. Clear? So there can be two ways in which we can do the two diagrams that we are seeing right now. We right now have seen the second. We come under the second one, where there is this host operating system. So roughly 10 minutes ago, I was telling that there is also a provision where there can be no operating system. So Windows 10 won't be there. Still, there is one particular system that can be set up directly over the x86 architecture, and that system will take care of multiple operating systems, just like what this Oracle VirtualBox did for us. Alright, so VMware's ESXi is one such system. It is one of those type of hypervisor, is what we say. Hypervisor. Alright, there are again types of hypervisor. It is a type 1 hypervisor. So if we see this type 1, this description is very close to type 1 of hypervisor description. Okay? This is virtualization type. Type 1 of virtualization says virtual environments are considered full virtualization environments. It actually should be bold till here. Type 1 virtual environments. So these are considered as full virtualization environments and have VMs running on hypervisor that interacts with the hardware. Alright, so instead of Windows 10, there would be a hypervisor that would be interacting with the x86 architecture. Now, why do you feel this is an advantage or a disadvantage? What do you feel if it is an advantage or a disadvantage?
Advantage is you want to make a system which is focused on multiple.
Perfect. If my intention is only to run multiple systems, alright, why would I even for that matter require a Windows 10 to do that? Because if there are 8 gigs of RAM for my system and I can allocate only 2 and 2 GB, 4 GB for 2 operating systems, I am still somehow wasting the 4 GB, the remaining 4 GB, just because I don't want much of a payload to be on Windows 10. Alright, so instead of that, I can simply have an application that will do the job of this operating system, entire operating system, and can allocate other remaining entire 4 GB to 2 more systems. So there can be 4 systems in place. Also, understood. Alright, so this is one of those technical advantages. The other advantage is from a risk perspective. So if there is a Windows 10, I really require this Windows 10 to be protective first. It should not be vulnerable. So if Windows 10 is not updated frequently, if I am using an outdated version of Windows 10, if I am using a pirated version of Windows 10, if I am not using an antivirus with Windows 10, alright, if I am keeping all the firewalls open for Windows 10 operating system so that anyone can come and interact with this operating system, then I am actually giving the attacker some more advantages. Alright, whereas if I am not even having an operating system at all, antivirus ka part, hardening, OS hardening kehte hain usse, kernel ko koi access na kar paaye, ye sara part nikal jayega. Low maintenance and high availability of systems. Samajh mein aaya? Windows 10 ke jaisa aapko kisi operating system ko manage hi nahi karna padega. You can simply turn on that particular system physically and the application will start, although it will not look so beautiful as Windows 10. It will have a black screen, or it will have only two different colors ka screen, black screen and yellow screen, but it will get the job done. Our intention was to only run four systems at a time. It will get those four systems on at the same time. Alright, so such is the architecture of full virtualization, type 1. Type 2 is also full virtualization. The second diagram is also full virtualization, wherein everything has been virtualized at one end and set up at the other end. Okay, this entire thing can be given to the customer. Similarly, the upper one entirely, it can be given, handed over to the customer to be used at his or her end. Alright, so quick homework would be for you all to find out Gmail ka jo, agar if it is virtualized, what type of virtualization is it? Type 1 mein aata hai ya type 2 mein aata hai? If it is virtualized, or is it having a dedicated server? Samajh mein aaya question kya hai? Theek hai, to aapko pata chal jayega ki kya ho raha hai. Do they have an operating system? Jis operating system ke upar unhone application dala hai, us application ke andar se jo services chal rahe hai, wo humko Gmail pe as a service milta hai. Is it that way, or do they have a dedicated server running only services of Gmail, what we are using? Alright, have a small reference check on this particular thing. Fine, you will actually clearly know what is type 1 and type 2 by hunting out these examples. Fine, then there is something known as para-virtualized environments. Okay, before that, alright. So, para-virtualized environments is the third part. Which offers performance gains by eliminating some of the emulation that occurs in full virtualization environments. So you may get partially for example, the flexibility that we saw right now for setting up another operating system inside this operating system using Oracle VirtualBox, you may get a limited set of features. You may, if the RAM, hypothetically speaking, if the RAM of your particular PC is 8 gigabytes, then you may not be able to use more than 4 GB para-virtualized. It will be limited to a certain end. This is a hypothetical example, just to give you a thought ki kya kya limit ho sakta hai. That comes under para-virtualized. You may also be able to set up using 6 GB, using 8 GB, but you will have limited features. Ab usme shayad networking nahi kar paoge, पूरी तरह से नेटवर्किंग नहीं कर पाओगे, या फिर सिर्फ लैन तक ही चलेगा, वैन में नहीं चलेगा. ऑलराइट, देयर आर डिफरेंट अ डाइवर्स वेरिएशन ऑफ पैरा वर्चुअलाइज्ड एनवायरनमेंट्स. ऑलराइट, फॉर एग्जांपल, यू टेक द सिनेरियो ऑफ डीमार्ट का, अगेन हाइपोथेटिकली स्पीकिंग, डीमार्ट का नेटवर्किंग. सो इट कैन बी सेट अप यूजिंग अ सिंगल सर्वर, एक सर्वर होगा, उसके अंदर जितने भी कियोस्क हैं, जितने भी काउंटर्स हैं, वो सारे के सारे सिस्टम वो एक सर्वर से चल रहा होगा यूजिंग अ वर्चुअल बॉक्स. सब लोग अपना अपना इंडिविजुअल लॉगिन कर सकते हैं, शायद हाइपोथेटिकली स्पीकिंग. ऑलराइट, बट नो वन विल बी एबल टू एक्सेस दिस पर्टिकुलर नेटवर्क फ्रॉम एक्सटर्नल नेटवर्क. किसी को आईपी शायद पता ही ना चले. ऑल्सो दोज हु आर एट द काउंटर मे नॉट बी एबल टू एंजॉय इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी. इंटरनेट एक्सप्लोरर उनके पास नहीं होगा शायद, विंडोज मीडिया प्लेयर नहीं होगा इफ दे आर यूजिंग विंडोज ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. सो लिमिटेड सेट ऑफ फीचर्स. Alright, that comes under para-virtualized environments. Offer performance gains by eliminating some of the emulation that occurs in full virtualization environments. The full virtualization environment, जैसे हमने वहाँ पे देखा USB feature भी था, alright, all those features may not even be available to a para virtualized environment. ठीक है, everything but with a limit, or nothing with a good limit. Alright, थोड़ा sarcastic था वो, nothing with a good limit, but fine. Other type designations include hybrid virtual machines and hardware assisted techniques. So there are also some not so what do I say, not so famous ones, but there are hybrid virtual machines. Hybrid virtual machines wo hoga, jaise I am taking the help of two different machines physically to create one particular virtual server. Alright, this machine has been connected to that machine and has also been connected to a third machine. All three combined with the processing power and the storage facility, I'm creating one entire kind of a server for a user. That can be done. ठीक है, so that comes under hybrid virtual machines. So three, four, n number of machines physically, but given a glimpse of as if it is a single machine and it is not a normal desktop, it is a server. Whereas on my side, it is three different. There are three different machines. So such type of machine is known as a hybrid virtual machine. Clear? Four types as per your syllabus. There are multiple types of virtualization. Okay? Next is virtualization management roles. It is very similar to your database management roles or operating system roles. There could be something known as virtual server administrator. वर्चुअल, अभी मुझे आप बताओ वर्चुअल सर्वर एडमिन और वर्चुअल मशीन एडमिन में क्या डिफरेंस हो सकता है? द फर्स्ट टू आर बिट कंफ्यूजिंग. परफेक्ट. सो इफ आई अगेन हाइपोथेटिकली स्पीकिंग, इफ आई हैव अ हाइब्रिड सर्वर, हाइब्रिड वर्चुअल मशीन, सो थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मशीन्स कैन बी देयर इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी. सो इफ आई एम टेकिंग केयर ऑफ दीज थ्री मशीन्स, आई एम द वर्चुअल सर्वर एडमिन. I am actually working on the server. Alright, there is something known as virtual machine admin. So whatever has been installed inside it, that will be administered, that will be managed by another role. Alright, that particular role is known as virtual machine administrator. So the I'll keep the VM open. So anything installed in this particular thing, alright, if I am able to manage those, I am right now managing the virtual machine. Understood? And if at all I am actually managing the host itself, Windows 10 को manage कर रहा हूँ या Ubuntu को manage कर रहा हूँ अलग से जो मुझे physically यहाँ पे दिखाई दे रहा है. So those are servers, Ubuntu server, Linux server, Windows server. Alright, if I am managing those come under virtual server admin, and anything installed inside it, if it is being managed, it comes under virtual machine admin. Okay, then there is something known as guest admin. Guest admin can also be some role जिसमें मैंने कुछ अपने, फॉर एग्जाम्पल कंसिडर दैट वी हैव सेटअप एन एंटायर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. उस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम में वी आर इंस्टॉलिंग एन एप्लीकेशन विच हैज बीन गिवन बाय अ वेंडर. सो वेन एवर देर इज अ वर्जन अपग्रेड फ्रॉम द वेंडर, आई विल अलाउ हिम टू एक्सेस माई पीसी बट टू अ लिमिटेड एक्सटेंट. ऑलराइट, लेट द वेंडर कम एंड एंटर दिस पीसी लॉजिकली, नॉट फिजिकली. लेट द वेंडर बी एट चेन्नई, बट आई विल शेयर फ्यू थिंग्स विद हिम so that he can enter this PC, but he or she will only have a limited access. All right. So such type of admin is known as guest admin. He or she definitely is going to deal with installing and uninstalling, and will be requiring some files from C drive, from D drive. All right. So by default, that role would be of an admin role, but it could be limited to only that particular application. So that type of administration is known as guest administration. Understood? Three very different things: virtual server admin, virtual machine admin, and guest admin. Okay, go through this entire slide. Let me know if you don't understand anything. Then, alright, so there was a mention of configuring the ESX server hardware. Alright, so no doubt, kuch doubt hai yahan pe? Nahin, toh main puch sakta hun kuch. ESX ka full form kya hai? This ESX is very particular with associated with VMware ESX. ESX was the previous name, latest name is ESX, lowercase mein I, ESX. Elastic Sky X I, integrated. Why Elastic, why Sky and why X and why integrated? Ya aap mujhe kal batana. ठीक है तो सो टू थिंग्स दो होमवर्क मिल गया आपको एक तो जीमेल का जो सर्वर है वो कैसा है इज इट टाइप वन हाइपरवाइजर टाइप टू में आता है पैरा वर्चुअलाइज में आता है कैसा आता है एंड व्हाट इज ई वो इलास्टिक स्काई एक्स और आई ये नाम क्यों पड़ा उसका राइट इलास्टिक इज समथिंग दैट यू कैन राइट नाउ गिव द रीजन इलास्टिक इसलिए बिकॉज इट कैन बी डायनामिकली अरेंज अभी आपने फॉर एग्जाम्पल सेटअप कर दिया वर्चुअल मशीन का रैम 4GB होगा देन आफ्टर ओपनिंग द होस्टिंग दैट एंटायर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इफ यू फील कि 4GB थोड़ा कम पड़ रहा है यू कैन एक्चुअली इंक्रीज इट टू 6GB शट डाउन कर दो अंदर वाले ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को जो आपने विंडोज 10 के ऊपर इंस्टॉल किया है राइट गो टू प्रेफरेंसेज प्रेफरेंसेज में जाके रैम का साइज इंक्रीज कर दो उसी तरह ऐसा लग रहा है कि 4GB से कम भी चल जाएगा काम तो कम कर देंगे So if you can dynamically arrange few things, dynamically organize few things, hard disk size, alright, paging size, graphic memory, video memory, wo sab change agar hum kar sakte hain, that is why it was elastic in nature, dynamic in nature basically, alright. So sky kyun tha? Because it was pretending to be a cloud, rather claiming to be a cloud, on cloud, kahin se bhi access kar sakte hain. इलास्टिक स्काई एक्स क्यों था ये आप डेफिनेटली आप बताओगे वरना मैं जवाब दे जाऊंगा इफ आई कीप ऑन टॉकिंग आई गिव यू द एंटायर आंसर ऑलराइट आई वाज इंटीग्रेटेड ये पहले ही मैंने आपको बता दिया व्हाट वाज इंटीग्रेटेड ये आप बता दो ठीक है सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल सो अ वर्चुअल सर्वर एडमिन विल बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द एंटायर ईएसएक्स सर्वर वो ईएसएक्स जिस सर्वर पे इंस्टॉल्ड है वो सर्वर को मैनेज करने के लिए देयर विल बी अ वर्चुअल सर्वर एडमिन Then there will be a virtual machine admin कि उस पे जो आपने मशीन इंस्टॉल किया है उस पे मतलब विंडोज 10 पे फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम इफ यू हैव इंस्टॉल एनीथिंग इनसाइड दिस पर्टिकुलर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड अनदर विंडोज 10 लेट्स अज्यूम दैट देयर इज अनदर विंडोज 10 इनसाइड दिस विंडोज 10 तो सेकंड वाला जो विंडोज 10 है उसको अगर आप मैनेज कर रहे हो दैट इज वर्चुअल मशीन एडमिन And third one we have already discussed that if we are granting access to a particular guest, limited all the accesses but to a limited application or set of applications that would be guest administrator. Alright. So there are some threats known as virtual threats. अब यहाँ पे threat क्या हो सकता है? सिर्फ मैं bullet point बता रहा हूँ और उसके बारे में discuss करते हैं. Shared clipboard क्या हुआ? You have some sensitive data. In say one of the operating systems, let's assume we have three operating systems. वो जो diagram था, okay, let us consider this particular scenario where we have a host operating system. All right, host operating system के साथ साथ हमारे पास तीन virtual machines हैं. We have Windows, we have Unix, we have Macintosh installed inside inside Windows 10. ठीक है सो इफ देयर इज सेंसिटिव डेटा इन वर्चुअल मशीन वन और मैंने क्लिपबोर्ड का एक्सेस फुल दे दिया फुल कॉपी कर सकते हो फुल पेस्ट कर सकते हो फ्रॉम एनी मशीन एंड फ्रॉम वर्चुअल मशीन टू होस्ट एंड फ्रॉम होस्ट टू वर्चुअल मशीन वन ये फुल एक्सेस मैंने क्लिपबोर्ड का दे दिया क्लिपबोर्ड इज एनीथिंग दैट यू कॉपी गेट्स स्टोर्ड इनसाइड रैम वोलेटाइल होता है वो टेम्पररीली टिल द टाइम यू पेस्ट इट समवेयर राइट सो वो क्लिपबोर्ड एक्सेस अगर आपने पूरा पूरा दे दिया एंड वर्चुअल मशीन वन वॉज कैरिंग सेंसिटिव डिटेल्स एंड वर्चुअल मशीन टू बिलोंग टू अनदर कंपनी विच वॉज नॉट सो सेंसिटिव इन नेचर एक तरफ आप वर्चुअल मशीन वन इज प्रोवाइडेड हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड एज अ सर्विस टू हॉस्पिटल एंड वर्चुअल मशीन टू हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड एज अ सर्विस टू अ जेरोक्स कॉपी वाला शॉप सो एवरी पेशेंट का डिटेल कैन बी कॉपीड एंड पेस्टेड यहाँ पे, अगर मैंने क्लिपबोर्ड एक्सेस एक दूसरे का दे दिया था. सो सेंसिटिव डिटेल्स ऑफ पेशेंट कैन कम टू जेरोक्स कॉपी एंड कैन बी टेकन एज अ प्रिंटेड कॉपी एंटायरली. दैट शुड आइडियली नॉट हैपन, दैट वुड लैंड मी इन जेल बाय द वे, अगर ऐसा मैंने करवा दिया था. ठीक है, सो क्लिपबोर्ड एक्सेस इज वन ऑफ द रिस्क, वन ऑफ द थ्रेट कहते हैं. शेयर क्लिपबोर्ड व्हेनेवर पॉसिबल, नॉट व्हेनेवर पॉसिबल, ऑलवेज वी हैव टू गिव मिनिमम सेट ऑफ रिक्वायरमेंट्स. तो मिनिमम सेट ऑफ रिक्वायरमेंट्स में बाय डिफॉल्ट क्लिपबोर्ड नीड्स टू बी प्रोटेक्टेड. बाय प्रोटेक्टेड वी आइडियली मीन इट नीड्स टू बी डिसेबल्ड. अगर आपको चाहिए पहले आप जस्टिफाई करो क्यों आपको शेयर करवाना है क्लिपबोर्ड, ओनली देन वी विल ओपन इट, अदरवाइज क्लिपबोर्ड नीड्स टू बी ब्लॉक्ड. ठीक है, द अदर वन इज की स्ट्रोक लॉगिंग. की स्ट्रोक लॉगिंग अगर आपने देखा है कि की लॉगर्स पता है आपको, देर इज समथिंग नोन एज की लॉगर. इफ आई हैव की लॉगर इंस्टॉल्ड इनसाइड माय मोबाइल और माय लैपटॉप एंड इफ आई गिव इट टू यू टू जस्ट लॉग इन एंड चेक योर ईमेल अकाउंट, एनीथिंग दैट यू आर टाइपिंग यूजिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर कीबोर्ड इज गेटिंग लॉग्ड पूरा का पूरा. सो योर पासवर्ड्स विल बी विजिबल टू मी after you have handed the entire physical device to me. All right, simply mujhe wo khali lock pull out karna hai and all your things or anything that you must have typed using the keyboard has been recorded. For that matter kisi kisi key logger ke sath screen recorders bhi aate hain. To kabhi agar aapne jo keyboard default hota hai wo use nahi kiya hai, bank ka khud ka, if you go and visit any banks in the internet banking, you get virtual keyboards. So if somehow you did not use my keyboard and you have used virtual keyboards, I am still recording the screen. मुझे स्क्रीन की वजह से पता चल जाएगा आपने कौन कौन से keystroke मारे. Alright, so those are keystroke logging, those should also be disabled. Alright, there is a very specific security criteria which checks all of these points. That is the keystroke logging disabled. Anything that I am using, that I am having an interaction with the keyboard in the application should not be logged anywhere, except where required. अब अगर मुझे transaction करना है तो transaction ID तो मुझे देना ही होगा किसी ना किसी को. Somebody has to store the transaction ID, but the PIN number and other card details need not be stored if I am not requesting them to store it. There is always a checkbox, save your card karke, whenever you are purchasing anything online. Right? If you choose not to save your card details should not be stored. Fine? So shared clipboard samajh mein aaya. Second is keystroke logging. These are two out of the four or five virtual threats. Third one is VM monitoring from the host. VM monitoring from the host. Imagine if you are just the host and there are three virtual machines. एक virtual machine दूसरे virtual machine को start stop कर रहा है, एक virtual machine दूसरे virtual machine को monitor कर रहा है. Alright, that also should not happen if the intention is not to do that. If the intention is कि हाँ there are three machines, एक machine दूसरे machine को monitor करेगा, then it is fine. But if there are two different, again the same hypothetical example, एक hospital है और एक Xerox वाला है, so there should not be any scenario where the Xerox copier should be allowed to monitor the machine of a hospital. Alright, so VM monitoring from the host should not happen ever if the intention is not to do that. Virtual machine monitoring from other virtual machine. Alright, so first one was from the host. Ki host ko bhi ideally nahi dikhna chahiye if the intention is not to do that. If the intention is to manage, then it is fine. Alright, kabhi kabhi aisa hota hai ki main if you have come across registering a website and hosting a website, you can use BigRock. There is a vendor known as BigRock, Reliance ka. There is a vendor known as GoDaddy. So you can use GoDaddy ka host and deploy all your web pages inside that host. ठीक है, तो आपके पास पूरा एक्सेस है. It should not happen कि GoDaddy में आपने वो पूरा website host कर दिया और GoDaddy is now monitoring your website का content. Content should be as per myself, my knowledge and my interest. All right, it should not happen कि मैंने आज कोई content डाल दिया which is not a false content, which is a good content. It should not happen that GoDaddy or for that matter Big Rock needs to call me and say कि नहीं आपने हमारी जगह पे डाला है. Even if it is a good content, we are removing it. It should not happen just because it is having the host. So that was the first, that was this point. We are monitoring from the host. Host need not stop and start anything without my consent if the intention is not to do so. Second is virtual machine monitoring from another virtual machine. Third is virtual machine backdoors. Backdoor is you are allowing something and you are not allowing something to enter. All right, let us read it. A backdoor covert communications channel between the guest and the host could allow intruders to perform potentially dangerous operations. So if at all we are saying that we are keeping the backdoors open, backdoor open kya hota hai? Say you always keep a scope of entering something new on the website. Alright, a website should ideally have that much space ki uspe aaj humne jo content diya kal bhi ek kuch content hum uske upar update kar sakte hain. But it should not happen that every source code is so visible to everyone that वो सोर्स कोड को कोई चेंज करके अपना कंटेंट उस पर ऐड कर देगा. ऑलराइट, देयर हैव बीन इंस्टेंसेस वेयर सम ऑफ द गुड कंपनीज वेबसाइट्स हैव बीन डीफेस्ड और उस पर आ जाता है दिस वेबसाइट हैज बीन हैक्ड बाय एक्स वाई जेड हैकर. ऑलराइट, व्हाट इज नॉट नोन इज व्हाट इज नॉट सो वाइडली नोन इज कि एक बार आपने आपको वो पीसी सर्वर जो था वो हैक हो गया, वेबसाइट डीफेस हो गया, आपने पुराना कंटेंट वापस ले आया. बट देर आर हैकर्स हु गो फॉर द बैकडोर एंट्री. बैकडोर एंट्री वैसा हो गया कि व्हेन दे हैव एक्चुअली डीफेस्ड दैट वेबसाइट दे लेफ्ट समथिंग इन द कोड जो उसको पता चल गया. दे हैव आइडेंटिफाइड दैट इवन इफ यू कम अप विद द न्यू कोड ऑल द और द प्रीवियस कोड तो भी ये वाला पार्ट चेंज नहीं होगा, दिस पार्ट विल रिमेन सेम. सो अगर उस पार्ट पर मैं अपना एक सॉफ्टवेयर डाल दूं तो भले आप अपना पुराना कोड वापस उस पर डालो या कोई नया कोड लेकर आओ, ये वाला पार्ट तो चेंज नहीं होगा, मुझे पता चल गया. सो दैट टाइप ऑफ दैट विल ऑलवेज गिव मी एन एंट्री टू दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट, दैट इज नोन एज बैकडोर. ऑलराइट, सो यू नीड टू आइडियली डिसेबल ऑल द बैकडोर्स इफ देयर इज अ स्कोप. व्हेनेवर रिक्वायर्ड लेट इट बी अपडेटेड, फिर वापस उसको पूरा लॉक कर दो, फिर जब रिक्वायरमेंट है तब अपडेट करो, ओपन करके फिर क्लोज करो. ऑलराइट, सो नो बैकडोर एंट्री शुड बी परमिटेड, फाइन. सो दीज आर ऑल वर्चुअल थ्रेड्स एज पर योर सिलेबस. सम टॉप 5 वर्चुअल थ्रेड्स ऐसा भी होता, देर आर एन नंबर ऑफ वर्चुअल थ्रेड्स. ऑलराइट, अंडरस्टूड. शेयर्ड क्लिपबोर्ड क्या हुआ? शेयर्ड क्लिपबोर्ड इज कॉपी पेस्ट का, आपने किसी को भी एक्सेस नहीं दिया. नथिंग कैन बी कॉपीड फ्रॉम वन वर्चुअल मशीन पेस्टेड टू अनदर वर्चुअल मशीन. कीस्ट्रोक लॉगिंग इज आई हैव डिसेबल्ड एवरी कीस्ट्रोक लॉगिंग. कहीं पे भी किसी के भी कीबोर्ड को ट्रैक नहीं किया जाएगा, कहीं पे भी किसी के कीबोर्ड को छोड़ो डेस्कटॉप का भी वीडियो नहीं निकाला जाएगा. ऐसा हम सेटअप कर सकते हैं. ऑलराइट, दैट इज कीस्ट्रोक लॉगिंग. थर्ड इज वीएम मॉनिटरिंग फ्रॉम द होस्ट. इवन इफ यू आर द होस्ट, यू मे आई मे नॉट परमिट यू टू मॉनिटर माई कंटेंट. ऐसा होगा, दैट कैन बी डन. फोर्थ इज वर्चुअल मशीन मॉनिटरिंग फ्रॉम अनदर वर्चुअल मशीन. Alright, two different virtual machines need not monitor each other if there is no purpose to do that. Alright, last one is virtual machine backdoors. Nothing should be left as an open thing. Everything should be closed. A closed system is what we see. Fine. Go through the text now about virtual threads. Done. First one done. Second. All right. Brilliant, bro. Any doubt to those who are online? Any doubt? All right. We now come to specifically the security part of ESX and ESXi. So ESX, very few companies are using it. Those who are actually dealing with the legacy system. Legacy system is they have developed something basis the old, the newest technology. But then it has eventually become an old technology. But they don't need to. They don't feel the need to upgrade that particular module or that particular application just because something new has come. Alright, there are certain companies who do that. Alright, such systems are known as legacy systems. So that is why ESX is still prevailing in these systems. Alright, although ESX was decommissioned, ESXi is the latest one, but there are companies still using ESX. Alright, so again, there are some categories of server applications. There is something known as category 1, wherein we are talking about vulnerability. Ab vulnerability kya aati hai? Last time in the last session we discussed about threats and vulnerability. Threats are external to the system. Vulnerabilities are inside the system. So threat kya hoga? There are always some hackers available outside. So hacking is one of the threat. Vulnerability kya hogi? I don't have antivirus installed in my machine if it is a Windows machine. So Windows machine without an antivirus is ideally open for different examinations. Alright, so no antivirus becomes a vulnerable. Because of not having any antivirus, my system becomes vulnerable. So anyone can exploit that particular part. Alright, so threat is external, ideally, mostly external in nature, and vulnerability is mostly internal in the within the system. So categories of ESX and ESXi security. Category 1 says there are some vulnerabilities that allow an attacker immediate access into a machine, allow super user access or bypass a firewall. Alright, so if it is a not so, imagine using a Windows XP machine when the all the supports have actually been formally decommissioned. There is no formal support for, although there was one after just after WannaCry, but there is no formal support given to Windows XP as of now. So imagine you running an entire server of Windows XP. Windows XP also had a server edition. So and running a company out of it. So Microsoft themselves are not supporting that particular part. So by default, it is open for anyone to attack if there is no support. So if there comes up a new system as of now, immediately your previous system becomes outdated. So why to run an outdated system? That outdated system will come under category 1, wherein the vulnerability will directly allow a user to gain the entire control of your Windows XP in that particular case. Alright, I am not targeting Windows XP, I am just giving an hypothetical example. So vulnerabilities that allow an attacker immediate access into a machine, allow super user access. Alright, all the kernel files, kernel commands will be able to run by that particular malicious minded personality. Alright, that can be run. So that comes under category 1. Then there is second category which says vulnerabilities that provide information that have a high potential of giving access to an intruder. So if I have a file saying that this is the username, that is the password of this particular user, and there is McAfee antivirus installed, and there is this. I make an index of all those things available in my system and put it on the desktop. Alright, so anybody who can simply somehow click on that particular file which was not protected on the desktop will have access to all the controls which are present, and then evaluate which control do I not have, so that that particular control, that particular vulnerability can be exploited. Alright, so by default you have kept it closed, but you have kept into, you are revealing something which is revealing a lot. Alright, you have kept everything, you have stored everything inside an email. Email has a password, but that email and password is stored in a text file which can simply be double clicked and open, and it can be seen. Alright, so that comes under category 2, vulnerabilities that provide information that have a high potential of giving access to an intruder. Alright, then there is category 3 which says vulnerabilities that provide information that potentially lead can lead to compromise. Alright, that you have an information which is related to something which can cause harm. Alright, see, the server application says vulnerability that may result in unauthorized users viewing or possibly accessing. If you have not blocked the remote communication, see, for every PC, we can actually set it up if it can be remotely viewable or not. See, over here, right now you can see on the desktop, it says allow remote assistance connection to this computer. By default, it is checked. So it means I am allowing anyone to get connected to this PC. Alright, agar main ye band karke apply aur okay kar do, immediately kisi ko bhi is PC ko access karna hai, wo by default to nahi hoga. That person will require my specific permission to allow that particular person to access, to gain access to this PC. Alright, for that matter, ye jo online lecture abhi chal raha hai, ye bhi band ho jayega agar main remote off kar do yahan pe. Fine. So that comes under this particular part. So agar kisi ne dekh bhi liya remote hai ki nahi. So now that I know that you allow remote, I will try accessing your PC by different types of remote. Alright, I'll try exploiting your firewall. कौन से तरह का फायरवॉल है मुझे पहले वो पता चल जाए, then I come to know that you have Cisco का firewall, Cisco का कौन सा version है, Cisco 5.3 firewall है अगर आपके पास, so Cisco 5.3 के क्या क्या पैरामीटर्स है, कहाँ पे मैं अटैक कर सकता हूँ, those all things can be checked. Alright, that comes under category 3. So three categories, पहला वाला क्या था, immediate access मिल गया मशीन को, दूसरा वाला immediate access नहीं मिला but उस मशीन में कुछ ऐसा इंफॉर्मेशन था जो हाई पोटेंशियल इंफॉर्मेशन था, जिसके वजह से यूजिंग दैट इंफॉर्मेशन द अटैकर गेन्ड एक्सेस. पहले वाले में तो अटैकर ने डायरेक्ट एक्सेस गेन कर लिया था बिकॉज इट वॉज नॉट इवन अ प्रोटेक्टेड सिस्टम. सेकेंड वाले में अटैकर ने थोड़ा स्टडी किया आपके सिस्टम को तो उसको पता चल गया हाँ ये पॉइंट्स ऑफ मैंने मैं ये जगह पे टारगेट करूंगा. थर्ड वाले में अटैकर को पता चला कि हाँ ठीक है ये सिस्टम तो प्रोटेक्टेड लग रहा है, लेट मी सी इफ समथिंग इज रीडेबल, अगर मैं किसी चीज को रीड कर पाऊँ, एटलीस्ट मुझे ये पता चल जाए कि रिमोट कनेक्शन अलाउड है कि नहीं, या मुझे पता चल जाए कि फायरवॉल का वेंडर कौन है, मैं वो वेंडर के गैप्स निकाल के फिर अटैक करूंगा. ऑलराइट, सो पहला वाला डायरेक्ट एक्सेस, सेकंड वाला मॉडिफाई एक्सेस कर दिया, थर्ड वाला रीड ओनली की वजह से अटैक हुआ. इवन इफ देर वॉज अ रीड ओनली एक्सेस टू समवन यूजिंग रिमोट, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट समथिंग गॉट लीक्ड. ऑलराइट, सो गो थ्रू दिस स्लाइड. Some key vendors have been listed over here. Done. Three categories of ESX and ESXi security. Alright, VM, virtual machine threat levels. Now we need to know what are the levels of threats. There is something known as abnormally terminated, then there is something known as partially compromised, and then there is something known as totally compromised. Ab ye kya hoga, aap mujhe batao. Totally compromised machine agar main bolu to kya hua? You gained access to, haanji? Category 1 of ESXi security hit ho gai. Category 1 can be total compromised. Alright. Partially compromised can be that you have gained access to some of the applications. Not all applications have been attacked. Alright. But some applications have definitely been compromised. Jahan se data aapke paas aa chuka if you are a hacker. Alright. That is partially compromised. Then there is third one, abnormally terminated. What could that be? Perfect. Denial of service. मैं आपको ही आपका सर्विस यूज नहीं करने दूंगा, भले मुझे एक्सेस मिला या नहीं मिला, मैंने आपको ऐसे जगह पे लूप में अटका दिया जहां पे आप ट्राई कर रहे हो सर्विस देने का, लेकिन वो आगे नहीं बढ़ेगा। राइट, डॉस डीडॉस ये सारे उसके अटैक टाइप्स हैं, एबनॉर्मली टर्मिनेटेड। राइट, परफेक्ट एग्जांपल। सो गो थ्रू दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स, दीज आर थ्री वीएम थ्रेट लेवल्स। We now come to something very specific to hypervisor. Hypervisor's risks. All right. So hypervisor is that particular part which is known as the, also known as the host of that machine. So over here, if we are installing anything on this particular machine, Windows 10, hypothetically speaking, can be the hypervisor. All right. It will be the host. उसके ऊपर जितना भी आएगा, उसका virtual machine 1, virtual machine 2, virtual machine 3 होगा. All right. Even if it is Windows inside this Windows, that Windows would be virtual machine 1. If there is Ubuntu installed inside this Windows, that would be virtual machine 2. Alright, so host would be this entire machine. Fine. So what are those things jo host ko kharab kar sakta, jo aapke pure hypervisor ko hi kharab kar sakta. Alright, so those we need to study as of now. So rogue hypervisor. हाइपरवाइजर ही अगर मैं ऐसा मार्केट में ले आऊं या उसको ऐसा पॉपुलर कर दूं कि दिस इज द बेस्ट हाइपरवाइजर, राइट, यू कैन सिंपली यूज इट एंड टर्न इट ऑन एंड देन इट कैन सपोर्ट उबुंटू, इट कैन सपोर्ट विंडोज, इट कैन सपोर्ट एप्पल, ब्ला 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 ब्ला, एंड लेटर ऑन इट कम्स टू नो, इट कम्स टू द लाइमलाइट दैट इट वॉज एक्चुअली अ रोग हाइपरवाइजर क्रिएटेड बाई अ हैकर विद की लॉगर। सो एवरीथिंग दैट यू इंस्टॉल एंड यू ट्रांजैक्टेड upon was actually seen by the hacker. Alright, so rogue hypervisor is the very first risk, that there are rogue hypervisors in the market, by the way. That is why you need to be very careful with the brand. That is why I always use branded hypervisors. So VMware ka ESXi is a branded one, and there are duplicate versions of ESXi too available online. Alright, so always download it from the genuine website. आपको अगर ESXi चाहिए तो VMware के उनके ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट से ही डाउनलोड करो। ऑलराइट, आपको अगर वर्चुअल बॉक्स चाहिए तो वो Oracle वर्चुअल बॉक्स का ही वेबसाइट है डेडिकेटेड, उसी से डाउनलोड कीजिए। नो नीड टू गो टू एनी थर्ड पार्टी वेबसाइट जो बोलेगा कि इसमें प्री एडेड बेनिफिट्स है, नो नीड टू डू दैट बिकॉज दोज माइट बी रॉग हाइपरवाइजर्स। ऑलराइट, सो दैट वॉज वन। Second one is external modification of the hypervisor. If the hypervisor is not protected enough, वो hypervisor allow कर देगा कि you can access the PC, you can access anything which can be externally connected. All right, that needs to be seen. That is one of the risks. External modification नहीं होना चाहिए hypervisor के पास. No one should be remotely able to configure my systems if I am not permitting that particular person to. All right, ideally no one should get the remote access for configuring systems. That is second, external modification of the hypervisor. Third one is VM escape. VM escape ऐसा होता है that one particular VM can is able to manage the other VM without the host being known. तो host को bypass करके चले जाते हैं. Alright, without the knowledge of the host, the Xerox copier can see the files of hospital management files. Alright, without the knowledge of the host, that can also be done. There are types of attacks known as escape attacks. Alright, very popular in 2004, between 2004 to 2007, जब VM बहुत नया नया था. Alright, so वो time पे VM escapes बहुत सारे थे. So escape is by default bypassing. Without my knowledge, you are managing something that I used to manage. That is something bypassing. Or without my knowledge, you are going to another level that you are not supposed to. That is something again VM escape. So the last one is increased denial of service risk. So DOS is definitely one of the risks anywhere if it is virtually connected. Virtually आपने एक simple सा router भी configure किया, वो router का भी DOS ping of death कर सकते हैं हम. Ping of death इतने बार उसको पिंग करेंगे कि वो राउटर इंटरनेट फैसिलिटीज या शेयरिंग फैसिलिटी ही ना दे पाए, कैपेबिलिटी ना हो उसकी, बाद में इतना पिंग हमने कर दिया उसको 1.5 लाख पिंग पर सेकंड, अगर हमने कर दिया तो थिंग ऑफ डेथ उसे कहते हैं. राइट, सो दैट शुड नॉट हैपन, दैट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द रिस्क. सो दीज आर द फोर रिस्क इन अ हाइपरवाइजर. सिंपल रिस्क, इतने कुछ टीडियस नहीं है. राइट, सिंपल से रिस्क है. आपको ये चार चीजें बेसिकली, दीज आर टॉप फोर आउट ऑफ रफली 150-200 ऑड रिस्क. टॉप फोर रिस्क आपके सिलेबस के हिसाब से ये है. Have a look at it. पढ़ लो एक बार. We saw virtualization system security issues, जिसमें से ESXi security हमने देखा है. अब storage backup and recovery, let us visit it tomorrow. छोटा सा ही टॉपिक है. स्टोरेज में क्या आएगा, बैकअप और रिकवरी एक साथ होगा उसमें. एंड वर्चुअलाइजेशन सिस्टम, अच्छा दिस इज ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन टुडे, वर्चुअलाइजेशन सिस्टम वल्नरेबिलिटी, बेसिक वल्नरेबिलिटीज भी आती है. सो ओनली स्टोरेज कंसिडरेशन एंड बैकअप एंड रिकवरी, दिस रिमेन्स फ्रॉम क्लाउड सिक्योरिटी. इट विल बी कंप्लीटेड एंड यूनिट 2 विल बी टारगेटेड टुमारो. ऑलराइट, लेट्स सी इफ यू कैन स्टार्ट एंड फिनिश विद एंटायर नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी टुमारो. Target is, but let's see if it is feasible. Okay. Any doubt over here till now? Concepts are clear. Basic understanding clear. Everything else, speaking from an examination point of view, you can actually manipulate the answers. If you know CIA, if you know basic threats, basic vulnerabilities, ab idhar udhar ghuma ke likhoge, those are connected. Theek hai? This is only from an examination point of view. But if you really want to learn, understand what are the basic concepts, that's it. Everything can be built later. ये अपना जो base है ये clear रखना, ठीक है? VMware क्या करेगा? How is it different from other platforms? Alright? Combine 2 to 3 VMs over something? जैसे ESXi है. ESXi will have Windows 10, Ubuntu and other server running parallelly. Can we combine 2 ESXi and can run 1 ESXi with running 3 systems in parallel and another ESXi running 2 more systems in parallel? Can we do that? So basic understanding हमने ESXi का तो ले लिया. There is also something known as vSphere and vCenter. Read about it. क्या करता है वो? vSphere and vCenter. Alright. One of them helps you to connect multiple ESXi's simultaneously. Alright. And the other one actually creates an environment for that. So vSphere, vCenter के बारे में वो आपके syllabus में नहीं है, but if you are interested in cyber security, you need to know what lies beyond that particular ESXi. So single operating system tha, wo multi-user operating system ho gaya, uske upar humne virtual machine dal diya. Kafi sare virtual machine ho sakta hai, mere ye operating system ka limitation hai. Isme sirf 8 GB RAM hai, isme sirf itna dual core processor hai, ya core i3 hai, 3 processors hai with some threads. Alright, iski capability utni hi ho sakti hai. So can something be done? To uske case mein humne ek architecture aisa dekha jisme there cannot be a host and directly there can be some application that will run, that will do the job of the host. Wo dekh liya humne. Ab can we combine such more applications? Can we combine? Wo ESXi was one of them. Can we combine ESXi? The answer is yes. How can that be done? Procedure wise nahi, but can it be done and what can get it done? Ye dekh lo as an added advantage. अब वो जान गए ना तो फिर अभी क्या हम बैकअप और स्टोरेज में पढ़ने वाले, वो बाय डिफॉल्ट आपको पता है. Alright, because that is done to ideally have a common storage or to ideally have a backup of one entire system to a different physical location. मेरे पास हैदराबाद से भी 3 servers connect हो रहे हैं, मेरे पास चेन्नई से भी 3 servers connect हो रहे हैं in Mumbai. So Mumbai में backup आ रहा है हैदराबाद का और चेन्नई का एक साथ. Alright, and those systems are talking to each other. So that can be done. Alright, using one of these two. Okay, so okay, fine, we conclude this session today. Tomorrow we move.